Pransinada is the start of a new and better world. The motive of creating this city is to make a greener city that uses methods of sustainability in everyday life, while everyone lives their life to the fullest and enjoy all the luxuries. The goals of the city are to maintain its low air pollution level, reduce the temperature of the city, and practice reforestation and afforestation whenever necessary. The city has almost zero carbon emission due to the fact that everything here is used and built, keeping in mind that nature cannot be harmed in any way whatsoever. A city cannot be made green until the neighbors of the city are also green. Therefore, Prasinada helps other cities to attain zero carbon emission as well, so that everyone can enjoy nature's beauty while living in the most luxurious way possible. The young population is the most important asset for the future of any place. The priority in Prasinada is to make students independent, confident, and rational human beings. Education at Prasinada is not just theoretical, but also practical. It is inspired by Finland and partially from the United States. Teaching is done by using participative measures, by giving students projects and involving them in various activities for better learning of the subject. Teaching is one of the most important professions of the world. Hence, it is one of the highest paid professions in Prasinada. Physical education is a compulsory part of the school curriculum for every grade so that children are fit and healthy and ready to serve when they graduate school instead of being obese and unhealthy.
Citizens of Prasinada are well aware that it's not only government's responsibility but also their own to make their city sustainable. Therefore, they have adopted a lifestyle which makes their city sustainable. Cycling is quite common in Prasinada. They use LED which consume 80-85% less electricity than conventional lighting sources and have much higher operating lifetimes. They practice rainwater harvesting. They use their kitchen and garden waste to create compost. Prasinada citizens work digitally rather than using papers.
Prasinada holds elections every 3 years to elect one main mayor and other ministers for other important tasks in the city. The government in the city is democratic and anyone above 18 years of age can vote, provided he/she has no criminal record. The people are the most important part of the city and thus there will be zero tolerance with anyone who misbehaves with any citizen of the city. Harming nature in any way is also a criminal offense and can result in immediate imprisonment. The judiciary of the city works independently and no one can influence the judgment of the judiciary, not even the mayor. The judiciary would be made of a judge and a jury made of 12 common civilians to ensure that the perfect verdict is given. The city has well-trained police officers and cyber cells for the security of its citizens.
Prasinada greenery is maintained by following steps: environment-friendly concrete, projects for green city, seed balls, individual contribution. Environment-friendly concrete. Every 1000 kg of cement results in 900 kg of carbon dioxide. By substituting some of the cement in the concrete mix with the waste product fly ash, recycled glass and more, will reduce carbon footprints about 25%. This is called environment friendly concrete. Projects for green city. Prasinada government welcome and encourage new sustainable development projects. Seed ball. Seed balls provide an easy and sustainable way to cultivate plants in a way that provides a larger window of time when sowing can occur. Seed ball consists of a variety of different seeds rolled within a ball of clay. Individual contribution. Prasinada citizens maintain greenery of their residential area and green area by manual mowing, hoeing and weeding around the seedling, pruning of shoots and lateral around the seedling, fertilizing with compost, maintenance of irrigation system and more.
Prasinada uses a thriving system where organic, recyclable and non-recyclable wastes are collected in different bins. All the waste collected from these, along with sewage, is processed in the four different divisions. These four are the agricultural waste sector, wastewater sector, non-recyclable waste sector, and the recyclable waste sector. The agricultural waste sector deals with the human, kitchen, agricultural, and animal waste produced in the city. The waste is collected and then sent to the biomass management sector. Now, the wastewater sector deals with the desalination of water. Water is desalinated through the nuclear energy generated in the nuclear power plant. This water is potable and eliminates the problem of water shortage. The recyclable waste sector. The recyclable waste collected from bins is sent for recycling or reuse depending on the material. The non-recyclable waste sector. All plastics that cannot be recycled are subjected to cold plasma pyrolysis. The substances that produce only minute amounts of poisonous or harmful gases are incinerated and the rest is dispersed in landfills, which are later converted into parks. Prasinada also helps industries through guidelines and schemes like ocean fertilization and reducing the use of plastics. Prasinada has given all industries certain guidelines. These guidelines are: industries are to use hydrogen fluorocarbons instead of CFCs and hydrogen chlorofluorocarbons, and they are also encouraged to increase the productive use of natural resources and reduce emissions. Factories are also not allowed to release persistent organic pollutants. Apart from the guidelines, Prasinada helps industries in cleaner operation through various methods. These include chemical leasing, which is an initiative of United Nations Industrial Development Organization, and providing modern energy services to all factories and following the Kyoto Protocol, Montreal Protocol, and the Stockholm Convention.
Reducing temperature of the city. Carbon dioxide and other greenhouse gases are the elements that result in heating up the cities. Controlled use of carbon dioxide will, therefore, result in the management of temperature of the city and is important from the perspective of public health. Prasinada uses modern techniques as well as traditional methods. Traditional methods include the use of water sprinklers, canopy cover all over, and the modern techniques include two major inputs, green buildings and artificial trees. Artificial trees are the need of the hour. The artificial trees sucks up excess carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and then store it up, which is 1,000 times more efficient than a true leaf that performs photosynthesis. The leaf looks like a sheet of plastic, papery plastic, and is coated in a resin that contains sodium carbonate, which pulls out carbon dioxide out of the air and stores it as a bicarbonate. We don't need to expose the leaves to the sunlight for photosynthesis like the real one does. This is not an alternative to trees, but a way to meet the modern requirements. The collected carbon dioxide is thus cooled and stored, and then used for other purposes, like in the food industry for use in carbonated drinks, enhancing oil recovery, organic chemistry, even a clean fuel can be made by mixing hydrogen and carbon dioxide, and in manufacturing industries. The green buildings. The green buildings are known as sustainable or high-performance building. It is a practice of creating structure and using the process of environment-friendly and resource-efficient throughout a building's life cycle. This practice expands and complements the basic building designs, concern of economy, utility, durability, and comfort. Prasinada emphasizes majorly on green buildings as they provide a healthy working environment. Green buildings are designed to reduce the overall impact of the building environment on human health and natural environment by efficiently using energy, water, air, and other resources, protecting occupant health and improving employee productivity, reducing waste, pollution, and environment degradation. Compensatory Act for Forestry. Compensatory Act of Forest will be implemented in the city of Prasinada. According to this act, every time a forest land is diverted for non-forest purpose, such as mining or industry, the user agent will have to plant as much as the forest area covered in some other land, or will have to give a fixed sum of money to the government. Compensatory Afforestation Fund Management and Planning Authority, CAMPA, are meant to promote afforestation and regeneration activities as a way of compensating to forest land diverted to non-forest uses. The government of Prasinada lays broad guidelines for CAMPA. The CAMPA Act is a legislation that seeks to provide an appropriate institutional mechanism to ensure utilization in effective and transparent manner. The money paid by the developers who have raised the forest land will be utilized for afforestation, regeneration of forest ecosystem, wildlife protection, and infrastructure development.
So now we are going to talk about the transportation sector of Prasinada. Prasinada is well connected to the outer world as well as maintain its own secretism at the same time. Coming to the public transport, Pransinada has a very good public transport. People prefer using metros and buses instead of using their own means when they are going to their offices or other destinations. The government is also very responsible in providing the facilities here. The city is equipped with system maglev trains that are very swift and efficient when it comes to short distances as well as the long distance travel. Coming to the airways of Pransinada, Pransinada has two part airports, a domestic airport and an international airport. Pransinada has a lot of trade going through the airways. Pransinada is one of the most important changing airports for many important airways. Coming to the vehicles part, Pransinada promotes the use of hydrogen vehicles, which ensures zero carbon emission. Adding to all this, to ensure that everyone gets instant ambulance services, the city has been laid with binary electric lines. On these lines runs the elevated ambulance. These gigantic 50 feet tall ambulances can be very crucial in a life-death situation.
Pransinada has energy generation sectors located on the outskirts of the city. It serves as a powerhouse of the city and caters of all the energy requirements of the city. It is divided into various sectors that tackle different energy-related problems of the city. The first sector is the hydromotive production sector. This is the area where most of the city's hydrogen-based energy is produced. This industrial area has a large power plant in which the chemical energy of hydrogen is converted into mechanical energy by burning hydrogen in an internal combustion engine. The input energy of hydrogen-based energy is produced in by a large system of windmills and by cold plasma pyrolysis. The second sector is called the nuclear energy generation sector, which produces the energy required for various activities like research activities using nuclear fission and nuclear fusion. Pransinada uses nuclear energy for two main purposes. The first is water desalination, that is to produce fresh water from seawater by evaporating it. The second is for irradiation. Private farmers use radiation to prevent harmful insects. Irradiation also kills bacteria and other harmful organisms in food. This type of sterilization of food occurs without making the food radioactive or insignificantly affecting the nutritional value. The third sector is known as the maglev production sector, which deals with all the maglev and superconducting related matters of the city. Maglev trains are also made in this part of the industrial area. The fourth sector is the biomass management sector. This sector produces the majority of energy required for the city. The raw materials used include dead plants, human and animal excreta, and agriculture and household waste, which are burned in an internal combustion reactor. The carbon dioxide produced is sent into a large greenhouse, which is utilized by plants. Plastics have become an inevitable part of our lives. We cannot completely cut down on plastic production. Pransinada, being an urban environment, also cannot restrict the use of plastic. Thus, to tackle this problem, Pransinada has adopted a technique of cold plasma pyrolysis. This process breaks down plastic molecules and produces hydrocarbons such as methane, ethylene, etc., along with the evolution of hydrogen gas. Pransinada produces 0.375 million liters of hydrogen annually using this. A ready supply of water is a human right, but access to safe drinking water is becoming increasingly difficult to achieve in many parts of the world. The problem of climate change and population growth are leading to new pressures on water. Hence, it becomes absolutely necessary that we find a solution to this problem and find a sustainable way of providing fresh water to all humanity. One method of providing access to safe drinking water can be to desalinize ocean water. As John F. Kennedy famously said, if we could produce fresh water from salt water efficiently, that would indeed be a great service to humanity and would dwarf any other scientific accomplishment. Pransinada uses an expedient way of water desalination, and that is desalination using nuclear energy. Basically, nuclear desalination uses excessive heat produced from a nuclear reaction to evaporate seawater, which is later condensed into fresh water, which is suitable for human consumption. Nuclear desalination is significantly the most efficient method of water desalination, as more water per unit volume is getting desalinized and loss of water is almost insignificant. This method is also completely eco-friendly and does not contribute to global warming at all, as the method of production of heat does not produce carbon dioxide. Other methods of water desalination, like through regular evaporation and desalination using hybrid plants, causes a lot of water and take up a lot of energy.
The foremost concept of sustainability is to conserve what we already possess for the future generations without relinquishing the needs of the present generation. Prasinada, being a sustainable urban environment, respects that concept and believes in conservation of natural resources like rainwater, which is conserved and utilized by the method of rainwater harvesting. This method is a remedy for replenishing of groundwater in an urban environment like Prasinada. This method is followed thoroughly in every building of the city.
Now let's talk about the low air pollution level of Prasinada. This is because, as an alternative to petrol and diesel, we are using the compressed natural gas, since it is not contributing anything to the pollution level of our city. More of the public transport, like the buses and other means of public transport, are being provided to the people. As people are using public transport instead of their personal vehicles, so fewer vehicles are there on the road, and the problems like traffic jams are being avoided. Also, the pollutants are removed from the exhaust streams of power plants and industrial plants before they enter the atmosphere. Particulates can be filtered out, and sulfur and nitric oxides can be broken down by the catalysts. Removing these oxides reduces the pollutants that cause acid rain. Prasinada has installed many industries for this, and we have seen the results that the pollution level is very low in our city.